I watched testimonies from the Fortunoff Video Archive at Yale for 4 or 5 years. And then I said to myself, you can spend the rest of your life doing interviews and watching testimonies, or you can do something with it. And I began to take notes. And then one day I put on it, I still have the envelope somewhere, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 kinds of memory that I encountered. And they became the titles of 5 chapters in Holocaust Testimonies, The Ruins of Memory. I decided to write a book about it. Now, writing about it is both a challenge and an exhilarating experience because you have to find a language to discuss an experience that people call unspeakable, unimaginable, incomprehensible. I don't believe the Holocaust was incomprehensible. It's very difficult to comprehend, but you can explain how it happened and who did it, and sometimes even why they did it. But you have to find a language with which to write about it. And for me, that was exhilarating. And it became my career. If you Google choiceless choice, it will say an expression invented by Lawrence Langer, my claim to fame. There was a selection in a barracks in Auschwitz. Periodically, the SS would close the barracks and go through and pick out people who were the weakest, take their number. The next day, a truck would come by, the numbers would be called, and they'd take them to the gas chamber where they would be killed. So this man said that his number was taken, and he knew that was the end of his life. Now, there was a prisoner clerk in the barrack taking down the numbers and putting them on file cards. After the SS, and he knew this clerk, he went up to the clerk, who was a friend of his, oh, please, he said, take my number up. He says, I can't. They counted the number of people, and I can't have one missing. He says, do me a favor, put somebody else's card in there. So that's what he did. He took out the card from his friend and put in the card of some poor guy who didn't even know what was happening. The next day, the truck arrived, called the number of this other man who had not been selected, who said, wait a minute, there's a mistake, but you can't tell an SS man there's a mistake. And this poor guy was sent to the gas chamber. Okay, so what kind of choice did this man have? That's an example of choiceless choice. In other words, it's not a choice between good and bad. It's a choice between bad and worse.